Now I'm winding up with my visor open because it's late and I have no idea how the audio will be. So if the audio is shite, excuse me, I normally do not ride with my visor open. Normally there's an empty street there. It's fully parked. The people walking here are dozens, if not hundreds. It's an army.
I have an army.
See, you can turn it, make a right turn here. No matter how hard you want it, they will block you. So many cars. Police on horses. I do hope my backlight is still working. Maybe I should have checked that before I would go into here, but no, no going back now. I can smell fireworks. And no, that isn't my bike, that's fireworks. Here we go. Here we go. So many police, MA, even more firework smells. It's quite fun actually to drive around here just to see what's up. Now I quickly want to park the bike very quickly. I need to check one thing. Because my phone is going off like crazy. Oh, live on tape. A Pichu. Not even a shiny one. Stupid game. Ah, damn it. Even more police spanning. They behave like sheep. Now I can go left for a through the village kind of look, or I can go straight and see more of the big supporters. I'm kind of stuck behind the Seat Leon. Where am I? Look at those, how many people! Seriously! So many cars! Bicyclists, pedestrians. I got nothing on you, haha. Well, you got nothing on me. Same way. If you don't smell fireworks, you will smell weed. look at it! It's amazing! More buses. Of course, I've seen it more often. Downside or plus side when you're living in one of them. But sometimes it just simply amazes me how many people they can squeeze in that small little stadium. Then again, if you see how many people fit in it, is it really small? If you want to break into any house in Rotterdam, at any given time, do it when Feyenoord is playing, because all the cops are there, or on the road. And when there are not cops, they are volunteers. And the weird thing is, all those people are coming out here tonight, on their free night, to sit on the lazy ass for 2.5-3 hours, because you will be there early, you probably won't leave there directly. And even if you do, you at least have at least 2 hours of sitting time there to watch 22 overpaid guys run around behind a ball. Who would park his car here? Come on! Asking for a burglary or scratches or... Oh, lower gear, better. It is amazing. There's all kind of people, it's not just one certain brand or one certain... You can't really pinpoint it. It is people from 80 plus, men, female, it's youngsters, it's gothics, it's emos, it's rappers, it's no race, no faith, no belief, no... Although probably I think half of it is white male, so that's the majority, but other than that, Muslim, Pakistan, African, American, when you live here for some period of time and you like soccer, you will start to go to the matches of the Kuip, of Feyenoord. And you can see here that the road is closed. Like I said, you cannot get closer than this. I don't know if that's visible or not, but look at the smoke. Somebody is having fun. Look at how many cars. So people are always trying to find the closest place to park. No matter how difficult it is, they will always try to be as lazy as humanly possible, because that is in the essence parking as close as can be, is just being lazy because you don't want to walk. Then again, having a bike is probably the purest form of being lazy, because you can park right in front of the door. I'm gonna end this special vlog here. My battery is dead. It can't handle my indicator or me when I'm braking. When I'm braking, so my brake light has power, this one also fades. But yeah, thanks for watching this special Inside Feyenoord vlog, and I will talk to you guys later.